You say you came for the tech news, but that look in your eye says otherwise.
Oh, saucy.
Yeah, came for the sauce. You'd think the delays, betas, and playtests would have helped EA and DICE fix enough of the issues with Battlefield 2042 that the players would be satisfied. But well, if you did, you're an idiot. Look, it's a complicated game.
Yeah, come on.
The game's ratings on Steam after its launch weekend are not complicated though, with about 73% of users not recommending the game.
Oof.
Some of these reviews are literally just lists of in-game glitches or even the more daunting standard features of previous Battlefield games like server browsers, scoreboards, voiceover IP chat, and just many things that are missing.
It's not there.
The specialists.
You can't even lean. You can't even lean over.
You can't lean, that's dumb.
Yeah.
It's one thing to have falling through a map be a regular occurrence, and another thing to have an unlockable sniper rifle that can kill a tank and half the time as a standard rocket launcher, really?
Just like in real life.
Yeah. DICE says they're working hard to fix the game, and honestly, I feel bad for them, because this is almost definitely EA's fault.
Yeah.
I pre-ordered it and canceled it.
That was a smart move.
Yeah, I bought Forza Horizon 5 and love it. The PC gaming world waits with bated breath for Intel to release its heavily anticipated Arc gaming graphics cards, but you might want to temper your expectations a bit, especially you in the back, Emily.
Stop it.
Leaked results for a Geekbench OpenCL test show an Arc GPU with 512 compute units, indicating this may be Intel's flagship part, scoring around 69,000 points,
nice!
While a 68,000 XT gets around 150,000. Now, of course, the GPU in this test is probably not running with the clock speeds or drivers it will use at launch, so there's no need to panic just yet. In fact, you won't ever need to panic over an unreleased GPU's performance, and that's the moral of this story.
Hey, take that one home, kids.
Don't get excited about anything.
Calm down.
Like Battlefield.
Everyone just calm down.
And a recent report from Reuters uncovered confidential documents from Amazon detailing the company's successful efforts to block or impede dozens of US state bills that would increase privacy protections for consumers. Great.
Yeah.
The documents state Amazon's explicit mission to change or block the US and EU regulation that would impede the growth of Alexa-powered devices by defeating restrictions on biometric tech for forced disclosure of what kinds of data companies keep on their consumers. Basically, Amazon's trying to stop laws that would let everyone know how much of their data is being collected so Amazon can sell more Echoes.
That's fair.
To be fair, isn't that what we all want? The reports have led some members of Congress to call for federal consumer privacy legislation, but they call for stuff all the time that doesn't get delivered, unlike Amazon.
Hey.
Prime is a good deal.
I trust.
Love those guys.
They are
yeah.
Dependable.
They're
Jeff.
Way up there with Facebook for companies I like. And EA. Now it's time for the quick bits, brought to you by the Drop THX AAA 789 audio amplifier, which features THX's feed-forward topology tech, reducing distortion by 20 to 40 decibels.
Whoa!
Distortion won't even know what hit it.
Blam!
This thing that delivers the performance of a Class A amplifier without the heat or weight, and is capable of driving audio to any pair of headphones with a balanced quarter inch and 3.5 millimeter outputs. And until November 30th, you can save $20 on the AAA 789 amp using our link down below, so check it out. I know you didn't see the quick bits coming, and frankly, none of us did. Apple's app tracking transparency feature is only available on iOS, but DuckDuckGo is bringing something better to Android.
Ah.
The company's app tracking protection feature is rolling out a beta version of its privacy-focused browser app, and it will block trackers it identifies on other apps because DuckDuckGo says that 96% of the most popular free Android apps have trackers that send data to companies like Facebook or Google. Sure, your ads will be for stuff that you'll never buy, but wait, it's probably a good thing.
Goose!
Do you buy stuff off the internet from ads anyway?
No,
I don't. I don't.
But apparently people do.
Yeah, they must.
Stop it.
Actually, I bought a coat for my dog.
Oh, Alex.
Yeah, off Instagram ad, it got me. The Pixel 6 left many pining for a Pixel 6a, and leakers OnLeaks and 91 Mobiles have now provided some renders based on that information. The cheaper phone will apparently sport a smaller camera bar and, wait, no headphone jack?
Yeah.
And no back-mounted fingerprint sensor. Google!
What
am I supposed to look forward to on this phone? A worse Tensor chip than the 6?
Hey, got him!
Back on to good Android news, though. The default Messages app is being updated and will translate the tap-back emoji responses of iMessage properly instead of making them show up as duplicated text. That's sick, actually.
Yeah, it is.
You'll still be the green bubble loser in your group chat with your iPhone user friends, but should feel a bit less like a second-class citizen, depending on your friends.
Mine suck.
Walmart is now making deliveries by a drone to two different regions of Arkansas in partnership with Zipline, which uses glider-style drones, and DroneUp, which uses quadcopters. Of course, all the mom and pop drone delivery shops will not be happy about this. Hey!
Huh?
You made this joke last week.
That was about autonomous trucks. Completely different.
And take me down to Bitcoin City, where the grass is green and the girls' avatars are pretty. Because El Salvador's crypto-loving president has announced plans to build a city on the base of a volcano that would use geothermal energy to mine Bitcoin and would be devoted to using cryptocurrency for everything. Bitcoin City will apparently be circular and represent a large coin, and the people will be NFTs. I need to go now? What? What was that whole thing? That, well, I read a bunch of words and I don't understand any of it. But you should come back on Wednesday for more tech news. We're going to start building a tech news city right here in Linus Media Group. We're still working a permit, but
I'm sure we can figure it out.
Yeah, it'll be decentralized.